Welcome to this first PowerMill Getting Started tutorial. In this tutorial, you'll be given an introduction to the PowerMill user interface, shown how to import CAD data, how to define the stock material and part datums, and how to save a project. The PowerMill user interface is laid out with a ribbon toolbar across the top, an Explorer and Browser window to the left, some viewing and shading functions to the right, and a status bar at the bottom. The rest of the interface is dedicated to the interactive graphics window. We'll begin by importing a CAD model from the examples directory that comes with the installation of PowerMill. Select the File tab and choose Import Examples. PowerMill can import a range of different CAD file formats. Scroll through the list of examples to locate the speakercore.dgk file, or simply start typing the name to reveal it quicker. Choose Open to import the file. Items created or imported into PowerMill will then appear in the Explorer window tree. You can view the model in any orientation you like. The preset views in the View tab allow you to see the model from any angle. For example, top, front, isometric, and so on. You may also use the view cube. Simply click on the direction to look from, and the graphics view aligns accordingly. The shortcut keys from Control 0 through to Control 9 will also orientate the view. The view can be rotated interactively. Press and hold down the middle mouse button and drag the cursor to rotate. To zoom, simply scroll the middle mouse wheel. The zoom will focus towards the cursor location. To pan, hold down the Shift key and the middle mouse button to pan around. To zoom to a specific location, hold down the Control and Shift keys with the middle mouse button and drag a box around the desired region. To resize the view to fit everything, simply press F6. The icons in the right-hand toolbar give you access to many of these functions also, as well as control in the different viewing styles for wireframe and shading. In order to start machining our part, we need to establish the initial stock material and part orientation. We define the stock material by entering the block form, and in this case setting a simple box shape, setting the coordinate system to use the global transform or world coordinate system, and then pressing calculate. By default, this will generate a block of material around our model faces. This can be edited to suit, for example, adding 5mm of material on top of the part, as well as changing the block display properties. Viewing from the top of the part, we can see that the major orientation lies along the Y axis. We want to change this so that our X axis is our major axis. We can also see that the global transform lies in the middle of the part, which we would like to shift to the top corner. To create a machining datum or workplane, we select from the workplane pull-down list the option to create a workplane positioned on the block. Select the corner position, like so, to create it. Note that the workplane has appeared in the graphics window and also in the Explorer tree. To realign the workplane, we can select it from the Explorer tree and from the right-click context menu, select Workplane Editor. We can manipulate the workplane through the icons in the ribbon, or graphically. In this case, we will select the blue axis arrow and simply drag its orientation towards the opposite corner of the block. Note how it snaps to the corner marked block top. Hit Accept to keep your changes. Since we want to use this workplane for our machining datum, we will activate it by simply double-clicking on it. We can now save the project for use later to complete the tutorial.